Show Network. All play, all day.
I'm Milton Berle, and oh, have I got a secret. Oh.
From Hollywood, the show that reveals all, I've Got a Secret. And now let's meet the star of I've Got a Secret, Steve Allen.
Hello, folks. Oh, there we go.
Hi. Hi, folks. That's all right. Thank you very much. Welcome to the new I've Got a Secret. Isn't it marvelous that Mr. Television is here?
Yes.
And his lovely wife, Mrs. Television, will be in a few minutes. Right now, however, I want you to meet our wonderful panel. Tonight's panelists are fantastic, such as lovely comedian Pat Carroll and the star of the new comedy series MASH, Mr. Alan Alda, the gracious TV hostess and actress Betty White, and Laugh-In's Richard Dawson. And there's our panel. Well, let's see if we can get a contestant out here. Hello. In there. Nice to have you with us, ma'am, in that very pretty dress. And what is your name?
My name is Irene Knoke.
Knoke?
Yes.
Knoke. All right. And where are you from, Mrs. Knoke?
I'm from...
Miss Knoke.
Santa Monica, California.
Santa Monica, California. Have you ever seen Irene Knoke, Richard?
Actually, Cano.
Thank you. Very much. Well, if you did, you probably saw her at the Dobridge Circus. She has brought along some of her friends from the circus, and we're going to open our door right now and see if we can locate them in center stage. Isn't that cute? Cute little critters. And there they are, critting over there. Well, panel, Irene's secret, whatever my mouth said, concerns these little critters. And if you'll whisper your secret to me, Irene, we'll tell the audience what it is. It takes all kinds, folks. And we'll start the questioning with Pat Carroll.
Thank you, Steve. Irene, would this secret have to do with something the animals did?
No.
Is it something about a familial relationship, because there are three of them there?
We, in a sense, we have to give you a yes, a kind of a weird offbeat yes on that.
Is there any kind of incest involved or anything like that?
No, you're good.
Not on this program. All right, one down and three to go. Alan Alda.
Irene, is some way in which you're related to these primates here?
Yes.
Above and beyond the sense in which we all are, you mean?
Yes.
Yes, there.
Is there? Do you have a very? I just have a sense of. Do you have a personal connection with them? I noticed the audience laughed. You seem to have a very personal connection with these.
Yes.
Very good, Alan. Two down, two to go. Betty White.
Well, I'm an animal nut, as you know, and that is the biggest chimp I have ever seen in my whole life. I mean, if he grew to be 23 years old, I don't think...
That's more of a gorilla kind of a
that's
thing.
That's kind of a big ape. Are the two smaller apes babies?
Yes.
How old is the center chimp?
I don't really know.
We don't really know. A very interesting question, however. Three down, one to go. Richard Dawson.
Irene, could it be that the owl baboon in the middle is not really a baboon?
You're absolutely
yes.
right.
Would it be your husband?
Yes.
Yeah.
In the suit?
That's right. Dickie. That's her husband, and the little one is her daughter. And the other one is her lovely son, who is studying to be a doctor. Why don't you let one of the little ones out there, Johnny Olson?
Yeah, don't let the big one.
And we'll look out. Hey, look out! Hold it. Wait.
Oh, that's
all. I'm not too sure that this thing is...
Irene, was your name Fay Ray at any time? How are you?
Look out there! Isn't that sweet? Betty White does love animals.
Hello, how are you?
Looks like my husband. Acts like him, too.
Male chauvinist cheerful.
Actually, the gentleman, for of course we have so identified him, inside the hairy suit, there he goes, is Mr. Harry Suit. No. His name is Janos Prochaska, and you've enjoyed his work in such famous pictures as Planet of the Apes. You've also seen him on the Andy Williams Show as the Cookie Bear. Janos, there he is. How are you? Good to see you. Give our best regards to our friends at the Dobridge Circus, and thank you very much, both of you, for giving us a really hairy secret tonight. That was good.
I've Got a Secret will continue in just 1 minute.
Are you ready to feel the noise? Are you ready to rock? Then crank it up to 11.
It's Monsters of Rock!
Monsters of Rock. 35 huge hits on 2 CDs and 2 cassettes. Featuring Warren. White Snake. Poison. Scandal. Winger. Monsters of Rock. The greatest hits from the bands with the biggest hair, the loudest guitars, and the coolest videos. Twisted Sister. Judas Priest. Nelson. Cinderella. You can't get Monsters of Rock in any store. To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order. 2 CDs, $26.99. 2 cassettes, $21.99. Rush delivery available. Monsters of Rock is not sold in stores.
Now let's see if we have another contestant backstage, huh? Nice to have you with us, sir. Would you tell the panel your name?
T.A. Preston.
T.A. Preston. And your home city is?
Amarillo, Texas.
Amarillo. A panel of Mr. Preston's secret concerns something, shall we say, unfortunate, decidedly unfortunate, that happened to him one night. Mr. Preston, if you'll whisper that secret to me, we'll let the world know what I'm talking about. Oh, my goodness. As I said, panel, it concerns something pretty rough that happened to him one night, and we'll start the questioning with Dickie Dawson.
Mr. Preston, were you injured when this occurred?
No, sir.
Not physically?
Not physically.
Not physically. Uh-uh. Did it involve a robbery of any kind?
No, I hope not.
I hope not.
No. Were you held prisoner by some exciting ladies or something?
No, darn it.
Would you like to be?
I'd love to be.
Did this happen while you were doing your normal job?
Yes, sir.
If I did your job, could it happen to me? Is it a likely...
More than likely it would, yes, sir.
The general thing could happen. There might be some question about the matter of degree. Thank you, Dickie. 1 down and 3 to go. Pat Carroll.
Well, we haven't established exactly what you do, Mr. Preston. I would gather from your Western regalia that it might have something to do with your work. Are you in rodeo?
No, ma'am.
Are you a Western country singer?
Certainly not.
Well, are you some kind of nut, then?
Just wears cowboy boots. No, actually, what he does, he's pretty big potatoes.
Well, then...
Oh.
Two down, two to go. Potato? Thank you, Pat. We go now to Alan.
You are a baked potato, Mr.
That's right. I'm baked potato.
From Texas. Now, do you do what you do in Texas?
No, sir, this didn't happen in Texas.
I see.
But he can do it anywhere.
But you can do it anywhere. And it was related to your work. Do you do your work around the country in various places?
All over the world,
and
yes.
It happened at night? Was this the kind of thing that would be likely to happen at night?
Probably a little
Did it happen in
front of an audience?
Well, they were an unsolicited audience, I'd say. There was plenty of people there.
There were onlookers.
I see. Not a paying audience, though.
No, sir.
No. Did this involve an animal?
No, sir.
Three down, one chance left. Betty White.
So you're not going to take that hat off and you're in a chimp suit. Isn't
that
right?
No, that's right.
This happened recently, I trust.
Within the past 2 years.
The past 2 years. Yeah. Was there any embarrassment to you at the time?
Well, I felt no embarrassment. I felt a little remorse, and yet I felt no embarrassment.
Some of us in his position would feel embarrassed.
It would probably embarrass the majority of the people, yes.
Were you sober at the time?
I don't drink.
Oh, well, then that's what I say. Were you sober at the time?
Truly, I was.
Did it concern a woman?
No.
Did it concern another man?
Several other men.
That's a very funny answer, as you'll understand when I tell you that what was going on was a poker game, and Mr. Preston's secret, if you're sitting down, as the old saying goes, was that he lost in one night $190,000.
Oh!
And it's even more unusual when you stop to consider that he is a good enough poker player to have recently won the World Series of Poker in Las Vegas. He's better known to his fans everywhere as Amarillo Slim. Betty says it would have been embarrassing indeed. Slim, how much did you win when you won that World Series?
$60,000. It was intended for 12 of us to originally play, and we'd played quite a lengthy session just prior to this. In fact, I played 2 days and nights with 6 hours rest in between, and only 8 of us agreed to go into the finals of it because it gets quite exciting.
When you're kind of dopey from lack of sleep, do you play a little worse? People do everything else worse when they're in that chair.
Well, no, sleep doesn't seem to bother me to a degree. This last session lasted 38 hours. Of course, that's quite lengthy, but... You have enough incentive to stay awake, you know.
Yeah. If this isn't too stupid a question, how did you lose the $190,000? Just lose again and again and again?
Well, like I said, I'd rather see early frost on my peach trees than to jump off out there and lose that kind of money. But occasionally the lamb slaughter the butcher, you know.
That's the way to put it. It's possible for any one of these people.
When I guess you know, little Flip Wilson beat me playing poker. Of course, there's a rumor the game wasn't on the square, but
By the way, Slim, are you married?
Yes, sir. Happily married.
Now, can you imagine Dick and the rest of the panel coming home and breaking the news to the little woman that you just happened to drop $190,000? How do you handle that when you lose?
I keep my gaming activities aside from my family. My wife. And children think I must be a clever booger. If I have a big loss, I don't tell them about it. I keep it from them. My wife thinks a king's a ruler of a foreign country and a queen's his bedmaid. She doesn't.
As a fellow poker player, but certainly not in your league, I wonder, would you just think of a card for me, please? Just any
think
card
of
at all.
A card? Is this your thing?
No, no, really. Right, any card
right.
at all.
All right, sir, I'm thinking of a card.
Would you tell us now what card it was you were thinking of?
The Queen of Hearts.
I had the king. You owe me $5.
I lose again.
Thank you, Dickie. Thank you, Slim. Lose again.
We'll be back with our guest star, Milton Berle, right after these messages.
Hey, don't buy those blinds here. Call American Blind and Wallpaper to save up to 82% on first-quality name brands like Levalure, Hunter Douglas, Duet, and more. They're the nation's largest factory direct dealer. They can get any custom-made blinds you want with savings up to 82% off retail prices. Take this brochure and call today. Gotta go.
Call now for this free brochure and learn how to save up to 82% through American Blind and Wallpaper. As a special bonus, this brochure features a blind measuring guide, so call now.
Hey, don't buy that wallpaper here. Call American Blind and Wallpaper to save up to 82% on first quality name brands in any color or pattern. They're the nation's largest factory direct dealer. They can get any wallpaper you want with savings up to 82% off retail prices. Here, take this brochure and call today. See ya.
Call now for this free brochure and learn how to save up to 82% through American Blind and Wallpaper. As a special bonus, this brochure features a wallpaper measuring guide. So call now.
Now let's meet tonight's special guest star, the one and only Milton Berle. To welcome you to I've Got a Secret.
I'm very happy to be here. Amarillo Slim just beat me for 190.
I'll tell you right off the bat, panel, what you may have already assumed, that Milton's secret concerns what's in the trunk.
Oh.
He brought it along tonight from home, and Milton, if you'll whisper your secret to me, we'll let the world know what I'm talking
Pardon
about.
Pardon me?
What's in the trunk? We only had a drummer. I'd give you one of these. We don't have a drummer. Is that
Yeah.
Okay, we'll start the questioning with Betty White. What's in the trunk?
Is it anything alive in that trunk?
No.
It's been dead for a long time.
Dead? Oh, is it dead? Dead.
I was going to speak to you about that. Does it have anything to do with anything like costuming or anything?
No costume.
No wearing apparel at all?
No wearing apparel. No.
Is it anything that ever has been alive?
Has been alive? Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
Oh. How, strictly speaking, sense you mean, though.
No. It's a joke that I'm speaking. I'm just clowning.
Now. Are you grinning? Oh, that's not like you. Uh-huh. Is it anything you're going to do anything with when it comes out of the box?
I don't... Maybe. But there's the buzz.
You're all right. One down and three to go.
Irving Dawson.
Right.
That's Richard.
Uncle Milty.
Yes, Booby.
Would this be anything to do with what has been responsible for you being one of the great American comedians?
In a way.
Would this be anything to do with your television show when you became the king of...
In a way, yeah, right.
Would this be the gag files that you used? Or the scripts?
That's about right.
That is substantially it.
That's it. Yeah. Jokes.
This is a stick-up. Hand over the jokes. Actually, to get the whole file here, we'd probably have to have a boxcar, right?
Well, I have 4.5 million jokes. I couldn't put them in here.
That's true.
Kind of young.
That's very good. I know Robert Aldebert.
Well, we do have in here a lot of the actual jokes from Milton's big show. Well, why don't we open them up and...
Yeah.
Will you do something?
These are the jokes that I did on my...
You've got both jokes in there?
These are really some of Milty's great...
These are some of the jokes that I did on the early television show. Shall I start one?
Please do one, yes. Notice the delivery. You folks can learn how to do
your
a joke.
Delivery belongs on a truck. Now, here we go. This is one of the... They're non sequiturs, so yes, separately. I was so poor in my younger days, we all had to sleep in one bed. I never knew what it was to sleep alone until after I got married. That's one. Now... How about the panel telling some jokes?
Sure.
We got the greatest joke teller, such as Alan Alda, who used to be famous many years ago, I think.
We have in here some jokes for the ladies, jokes for the men. The men's are blue, I believe, and the ladies take the pink ones.
All right, you pick one out. Pick one out.
We get the clean ones.
No. It's ladies' jokes and gentlemen's jokes. Ready? You're on, Bobby.
Well, I learned dancing from Arthur Murray, but later I found it was more fun with a girl. But seriously, folks...
All right, Betty.
Okay.
You're on.
A woman called up the police department and said, "I have a sex maniac in my apartment. Pick him up in the morning."
Good. All right, now we'll give one to the funny man.
I can't read this. His writing's written rotten. It's too close to the paper. A pretty girl walked into the psychiatrist's office, and he grabbed her and hugged her and kissed her. And then he said, well, that takes care of my problems. Now, what are yours?
It was written in Braille. My idea of embarrassment is when you look through a keyhole and see another eye looking at you.
You want to tell one?
Very good. Let's get Steve.
You don't want to?
Now, I'm going to make a present of all these jokes to Dickie Dawson.
Oh, thank you.
And you get nothing.
I'll tell you what, Pano, there is one other thing. You got into the idea of wardrobe a little earlier. There's something else that Milton brought along tonight that he's kept close to his heart for years. Milton, why don't you see if you can find it back there?
I'll get it.
It really is something very important in his family history. It's one of his dearest possessions. I don't think he'd go very many places without it. If you visit Hollywood, you might walk along Hollywood Boulevard some days, see a Milton Berle with it, and I think, yes, here it is. This dress is the first one ever worn by a man, that is, on television. Over 25 years ago, Milton was the first comedian to wear a funny lady's dress on television. Listen, would you put it on for old time's sake?
Swell.
I'll tell you, you want to help? Old time.
Just for old time's sake.
I want to turn your back to
this way, all right.
No, you turn the other way.
My way, I'm sorry. Yeah. All right, fine. There we go.
Ready? Wait a minute, just a minute. Just once. Don't do that.
I didn't know. I'm looking for the Velcro. There we are.
I now pronounce you man and wife.
There we are. Fine. And now.
I was concerned for the party.
Oh, they don't make them like this.
Yeah.
As I said, Milton was the first man to look like an idiot like this. No, but while we're talking you first, Milton, I would like to...
Can I get out of this, please?
No, I think you should only... You want us to get out of it? Seriously,
yeah, because the whole thing's a bust.
Pardon me, I'm sorry. Fine.
Where's your whistle?
I'm going to speak seriously, Milton, for just a moment on behalf of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences in congratulating you for receiving their 25th anniversary silver medallion for your important contributions to early live TV comedy. And in giving Milton this honor, I have some notes here. This is what the Academy said. I want you to hear it. It's appropriate that this award should go to the first superstar of television, the man who ruled the networks for years and years. He was really responsible for churches changing bingo night from Tuesday to Friday. He was responsible for the sales of millions of television sets. His performance record and popularity may never be equaled, and that's no secret. Congratulations, Milton.
I've Got a Secret returns after these words. Get ready to play. Gene Rayburn, Jamie Lee Curtis, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joan Collins. Check out all the stars on Match Game.
Oh, we're just one big happy family.
And then, where can you learn all there is to know about your favorite celebrity couples? On Tattletales. Join Bert Convy and get intimate with the stars.
Oh, George.
Catch Match Game at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific, followed by Tattletales, weekdays on Game Show Network.
I tried Ultra Thins with tabs, thinking tabs were just like wings. I had to leave a party with my jacket tied around my waist. Shouldn't have happened, but now I know why it did. Look how much panty an Always Ultra wing protects. Now see how small this tab is? No wonder that pad let me down. Wings protect better than tabs, and always has them. From now on, I'm sticking with real wings.
Now Always made shopping easier. Just look for the Easy Shop symbol in the corner of each pack.
There's an incredible freedom that comes from owning a cellular phone.
I've been expecting your call. Yes.
And once you experience it, there's no turning back. Hi, I'm Dick Clark, and now everyone can enjoy the freedom of the new Isis cellular phone from Philips with great cellular service for just pennies a day. You can make a call anywhere.
Hello.
Or get a call anytime. Okay. Change your plans?
Well, call us if you need it.
No problem with the Isis cellular phone. Stuck in traffic? Change that meeting before you're late.
Yeah, let's change that meeting to 10.
Got car trouble?
My car's broken down. Can you come and help?
Help is just a call away. This phone is packed with features like call waiting, three-way calling, and caller ID. It even has a 20-number built-in phone book. And here's a great feature, a one-touch button for instant access to 911. And it can even operate using regular AA batteries in an emergency. And best of all, there are no high-pressure salesmen to deal with. Just call the 800 number from the comfort of your home, and our friendly staff will help you. The phone arrives at your door within a few days, ready to use. And if you order today, you'll even receive up to 100 minutes of free airtime. So don't waste the day waiting for that call. Take the phone with you and make the most of your time.
I was expecting your call.
Get the Philips Isis Cellular Phone, a $199 value, now just $19.95 through this DirecTV offer, complete with battery and charger. But wait, call now and get this genuine leather case, a $30 value, absolutely free. And when you sign up for an annual rate plan, you'll receive up to 100 minutes of free airtime. We'll even pay any activation fee. It's an incredible offer.
Order your phone today from Worldwide Direct, because when you buy direct, you save a bundle. So pick up the phone, America. It's for you.
There has never been a better time to go cellular. And with your Philips Isis phone activated with local cellular service made available by Worldwide Direct, you'll have everything you need. To order, call the number on your screen. Along with your phone, you get a free leather case and rapid charger. Pick up the phone, America. It's for you.
Up next on Game Show Network, play What's My Line? Followed by To Tell the Truth.
Just a quick bit of time for one more contestant. What is your name, sir?
Maurice Wooden.
Wooden.
Wooden, yes.
Maurice Wooden from?
Santa Monica.
Santa Monica, California. Mr. Wooden panel has something to do with dogs, and if you'll whisper what you have to do with dogs to me, the whole world will find out about it. Uh-huh. And Kristen?
The secret panel.
Secret concerns something that Mr. Wooden does for dogs. We'll start the questioning with Richard Dawson. I think we just have one question apiece here.
Okay. Do you talk to dogs and help them understand their problem?
It's much more exciting than that.
You don't really have to give them that much information, Mr. Wooden, but that's all right. One down and Pat Carroll's turn.
Mr. Wooden, would what you have to do, if it's more exciting than that, have to do, say, with training the dogs for theatrical work? Are they show busy dogs?
Still more exciting.
Is anything more exciting than a show-busy dog?
If he keeps this up, he's just going to tell you the secret in a minute here. However, you're doing a very good job. Alan Alda.
If it's all that exciting, do you, I can't think of anything really exciting to do with a dog. And you look...
Good for you, Alan.
Yeah. Thank you. Because my family's watching. Do you train these dogs to handle bank robberies on either side of the law?
No, sir.
Well, that's exciting.
Okay, just time for a quick question. Betty White?
Well, with a name like Wooden, I'd stay far away from dogs if I were you.
Yes.
They might carry him home, you mean.
Do you teach dogs to sniff out marijuana?
No, ma'am.
Well, some people do, you know, whatever turns you on.
I don't know why that struck me funny, but what do I know? His secret is, panel, that he runs a canine dating service. He's the Cupid of the dog world.
I was going to say a
breed. Here's his business card. He actually has a computerized dating service. He doesn't just put your dog with any bum on the street, you know. It's very high-class stuff. Thank you very much, Mr. Wooden, and thanks to your dogs or whatever. And thank you. We will see you later, or we'll be right back, as the case may be.
All I've got to see are contestants receive cash awards plus these gifts. For our first contestants, his and her cosmetics from Mary Kay, including an assortment of Mary Kay creams, lotions, glamour makeup, and men's toilet paper. For our second contestant, a deluxe kit of roll-on decorator paints from Artex, the complete home and fashion decorator paint in the tube, Artex Hobby Products, Lima, Ohio. For our guest celebrity, a St. Mary's fine quality automatic electric blanket, machine washable and dryable, St. Mary's instant high fashion for your bed. This is Johnny Olson speaking for I've Got a Secret, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totten production. This program was... record.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.